All right, Shalom. Actually, Shabbat. Shalom and Sendet Salam. Now, greetings. This is Wyndham, Brother Ras Alonso Tafara, reporting for the Lion of Yuga Society of His Majesty, Haile Selassie I, and His Christ, Jesus Christos. Greetings to all and all. Special, blessed Shabbat Shalom. Today's Friday, what is it, July 27th, I believe, 2018. It's like 8:25 p.m. As you can see, it's getting dark, so Shabbat is coming forth. Now, we basically gonna present something we've been working on since December. Now, this art piece here is basically the cover of our latest publication, and these are some of the original images for the publication. It's a coloring book. Actually, the originals would be the ones on the wall and stuff like that, but then we have the tracing. And then after that, after the tracings, well, then we have what we had, presented as the originals. Nonetheless, these are just copies, and this is the original artwork for the cover, and we're actually quite proud. I guess not proud in the, in a vain sense, but we're very thankful that we've been blessed with the ability to begin and been endowed with a completion. So, yeah, we give thanks. And basically, we're actually working on the same image for my mom because she really liked it. She said of all the images that we've ever done, this one brings chills to her. It makes her feel tingly, and it makes her feel really, really good inside, she said. So this one's a little bit different though, because obviously this one being the cover of the colored book was supposed to like give the impression or the sense, the idea that there's still work left undone for completion, and to give us like a hint at the fact that it's a coloring book, because the coloring is still in process. And so, without further ado, we present the work. So basically, here it is. The Color in Him book, written and illustrated by Ras Alonso Tafara. Now, right off the bat, we're going to make mention that we kind of made a big mistake. Published by the Lion of Judah Society Español, and then coloring book images with added references, we misspelled it, and commentary, Rastafari studies. Now, we really don't care about that error, that mistake. We do not have modern equipment. The laptop we used, it took like hours, to correct one word, and then it would freeze and blah, blah, blah. We really don't mind. This is so special for us that we really don't care to correct it. I mean, it's what it is. We're not really educated in that sense, and we're not perfectionist. I mean, if we honestly had the equipment, I mean, it'd be a matter of seconds. But just to turn on the laptop we use, it's like hours. So, and here's the back cover, which we really like, and we knew that the letters were going to be a little bit, difficult to read. It's alright, we took that risk because we wanted this to be the back cover. We tried every single color. It didn't work out, so this is fine. Whoever is interested in reading will take the time to kind of just pay a little bit extra more attention to figure it out. So now, it's a really neat work. It's available on Amazon at a very reasonable price, $20, I think. It's like 74 pages with more than 74 images to color, trace, whatever. And it's like 130 something pages in total, because it's a lot of added commentary and reference. And that's the part that we kind of like the most, because we took it upon ourselves to like do something different. I mean, we teach in Spanish, and we can speak for hours, and we use all kinds of references, but we never really like direct ones to the exact location of the information that we borrow. And plus, we mix it up with our own thoughts and stuff like that, so it becomes presented not in the original form. But in this case, we decided to not only add personal commentary, but to present what others have to say about him and all these things. I mean, there's a lot to say. Basically, what it becomes, it's kind of like a, I don't know, like a puzzle, a treasure hunt, whatever. It's like these numberings and titles are to so they could be like a reference point for the image. And then what ones are supposed to do is then find that same number and title over here at the reference section, and then the information below will kind of give a brief understanding of how the images relate and their significance to Rastafari and prophecy, the Bible, and what many have had to say. Stuff like that. It's a really good work. I know, and I know for a fact. It's got like three different speeches of His Majesty, if not four. It's got very interesting points of view. I'll give an example. Like, for instance, that passage in Isaiah where it says Lucifer. We kind of point out how it's talking about Christ and how it's talking about His Majesty, but like, on the opposite end, in the sense of those that make fun of us, that say, hey, Rasta, where's your God? Your God is dead, you know, him that you raise above the heavens or exalt as a deity, you know, where is he? You know, that fallen star. In that sense, in that context, you know, speaking from an unbeliever, when they say, oh, that howling, that screaming, morning light and stuff like that. So anyways, so that would... You know, I assume that to many that's kind of controversial, because that passage has been attributed to Lucifer, blah, blah, blah. But the reality is that all scripture is manifested and fulfilled in Christ. And so how do we find Christ in that scripture? Well, we kind of look at it from the perspective in which we can see the light. And so, anyways, like another example would be like... Genesis 6:3, I believe, where it says, like, and my spirit shall not always strive with man. I mean, our position is that really it's saying we will always defend or strive for, not against, but strive with man, for man. For he has fallen, and we too are man, and I will be born in the year, in the 20th century. Now, that's enough for ones to kind of like figure out that, okay, that's not the typical common interpretation of that verse and stuff like that. So we'll find a lot of that in here, and that's our own pop, our own personal take in scripture, you know. Rabbi Bar Yochai, what's his name? Simeon Bar Yochai is another person that we found that takes the liberty to do this. He's like, oh, no, you're not supposed to read it like this. Read it like this. Now, an example of that same verse, Genesis 6:3, I believe. How do we get born in the 20th century? Well, the day is it can be a day of birth, a special day, a day where the king sits or is exalted, something like that. And so his day of birth, of manifestation, of his coming to life, is in the, it says 120 years, but if you read it 120ths, that means 100 times 20, or 2100s, that's equal to 20th century. And so we use His Majesty in his palace garden in Addis Ababa, saying, you know, with faith, courage, and a just cause, even in the 20th century, David will still beat Goliath, you know what I'm saying? So just to give ones an idea a brief idea of how there's a lot more to it than just throwing it out the window and saying that it's nonsense, you know? So things hidden belong to him, things revealed to I-9. So yeah, and I guess we'll finish off by reading the back. Once again, it's available on Amazon. It's like $20. I don't care. I mean, whatever. It's a good work. It's what it is. So it says, the Color in Him book features a collection of over 72 images, all of which are related to scenes from the Bible. The images reflect the ancient Christian traditional art style of the Ethiopian Tewahedo Orthodox Church, a great educational art, in fact, introduction to Rastafari. Copy trace. Color your way towards the light in His Imperial Majesty. Witness the Holy Scriptures come to life as you diligently study the images side by side with the respective commentary and references. Be not cast into outer darkness, rather enter into the light, which is the Color in Him book. Learn what has been said about Him that you have not heard, and teach it to your children so they be not of the deprived generation. Now, this is an example of reference that we give. The Lion of Judah and the New World by Theodore M. Vestel, page 194. On another grave occasion, Haile Selassie was the most colorful figure in the largest gathering of heads of state in the 20th century who attended President Kennedy's funeral. Here's another reference. Callous on My Soul, a memoir by Dick Gregory, page 87 and 88. The day of President Kennedy's funeral was also the day everyone learned who the most powerful person in the world was, the Emperor Haile Selassie, a black man. When the dignitaries, including Queen Elizabeth, lined up for the funeral procession, they lined up by protocol, and Emperor Haile Selassie, the Lion of Judah, the descendant of the Queen of Sheba, was first in line, representing what the people in Ethiopia already knew, and we didn't. People were stunned. Now, Sister Emmanuel wrote this last part. Says, Color in His Cross, an art effect, coloring, and teaching manual created by A.C. Tafari, a comprehensive and creative illustration of Old and New Testament revelations. In addition, this labor of love and livocation provides vivid visual, literary, and commentary explanations of the role that Emperor Haile Selassie, first, the Lion of the Tribe of Judah, has played throughout the world. History and innumerable nations, and continues to influence through the Rastafari consciousness movement, and most importantly through the power of Yahweh Elohim and message of Yeshua, HaMashiach, our salvation and kinsman redeemer, M. Emmanuel Saint Tafari, aka New Being Me. So there you go, you know, just wanted to present this publication. So you know, give thanks to Wyndham Yadon, because he taught Christ to I-9 in light of Rastafari. So before him, no one did that. And then the spirit of him whom he taught, you know, we received. And from thenceforth, all things were taught by that comforter. All things, you know. And we witness to those things being lived in the person of Haile Selassie first, resurrecting in spirit and in truth, free of sin. Christ, or Mashiach, HaMashiach, in truth, the living image and likeness of God in the flesh. So, Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Buen Sábado, Bendiciones a todo Rastafari.